Welcome to Brainsplain.
A horrible event happens in somebody's life, and then going forward, nightmares, flashbacks, rage, maybe suicide. Can a party drug be a breakthrough treatment for PTSD? Welcome to Brainsplain. I went to the rave-like Summer Solstice Festival in Madison, Wisconsin, because I wanted to find people who'd used ecstasy. I was looking for people who'd tried it in the context of having PTSD. I'd read the research, but I wanted to hear with my own ears how this drug had affected people's mental health.
I know that MDMA helped me come to grips with my PTSD. It was what brought it to the forefront of my mind that MDMA allowed me to think in an unbiased and an unstressful way about my PTSD. So my experience was outside the realm of psychiatric help, and I think it was very beneficial to who I am as a person. Even the people who I live with say that after that weekend, there's been a lasting change in who I am as a person. Like, more confident and like self-fulfilled, I would say.
Suffering from PTSD myself, I have been through things, and my own experience, it definitely lifted me and elevated me to another level that I wouldn't have been able to do by myself. I've done 11 years of a lot of therapy, and what MDMA did in one night was 11 years worth, and not even close. Like that, like yeah, what I could get in one day was just amazing. It's like the veil is lifted. Like you go to another place that's just all color. Like you almost leave your body, and like for me, what it felt like was home. Like it's where we go after this.
Yeah. Interesting.
Yeah.
I had a boyfriend who said, "Let's just do this. Let's just have fun. You'll like people more, you know." And I thought, "Well, why not?" So I did, and I'm glad that I did. And I don't do that anymore. It's been a long time, but it really changed the way that I deal with people.
Did it help you process through anything, or have any insights, or any lasting mental health benefits for yourself?
Definitely. I mean, I sometimes like to call it almost like a truth serum, I guess. Like, if you really want to get to the root of things with certain friends or my girlfriend, and like, I like to think of it as a therapy session.
People have talked about the effects of MDMA in that it has euphoria, causes people to also feel excited, and also it causes people to be more in touch with other people, feel more connection, and actually they use the word love. Does that resonate with your experience?
Absolutely.
Really?
Very much so. Every single one of those is right on the nail with it.
Did the effect last, help for a long time with PTSD?
Yes. Even to this, like, I wouldn't have even told you up to this point. It's just something that I would have silently suffered with, and I think a lesson that was taught to me through MDMA was, you know, the best thing for a mental illness is to wear it on your sleeve and to be open and honest and like present it.
What are the emotions or feelings or experiences that you had while on MDMA?
Complete connection. I feel kind of like I lose my sense of self, but not in a bad way.
What did people who had first-hand experience of MDMA have to say about scientific research on it? I told them about a clinical study that's just been completed. There's a phase 2 clinical trial that was published in May this year, and it showed that for firefighters, first responders, and Iraq war veterans, it helped with their PTSD, post-traumatic stress disorder symptoms, dramatically. 68% of the people who were given therapeutic doses of MDMA no longer met criteria for PTSD at the end of the study.
I have read that somewhere at some point, yeah.
Very interestingly, there are two doses that were therapeutic and were effective. 75 milligrams and 125 milligrams. The 75 milligram dose was actually significantly more effective than the 125 milligram dose. What's your theory about why that might have been?
You know, if you take a certain amount, like I've done it before where I've taken an amount where it's the stimulatory properties of it can be so dramatic that it's maybe a little bit hard to relax. And it wasn't, it, you know, maybe took a couple hours to really start to get into that state of, you know, really seeing things for how they are, and like, you know, being with friends, being extremely, you know, like just truthful and like finding deep-rooted thoughts.
Okay. When the doses were given, they were also given 8 hours of therapy the same day. These were 3 to 5 weeks apart. And the soldiers and first responders reported that they had felt that they trusted their therapists more because of the drug, that they also felt more courageous and able to talk about their own experiences because of the drug.
Yes, I can totally see that. It helps you open up, and it helps you lose your guarded walls. It helps the walls come down.
Yeah, and that was the study result. I was very surprised to see that it was only 2 sessions. Like,
yeah.
Take MDMA, work on yourself with a therapist for 8 straight hours,
right.
But only do it twice,
right.
And there's a lasting effect.
Yeah, yeah.
So here's what the investigators think about why it might be that it helps. They have a couple of theories. One is that MDMA releases oxytocin, which is known as the cuddle hormone. It's, it's a hormone that makes people just feel happy and open to new experiences. And also MDMA decreases activity of the amygdala. That's a part of the brain in charge of fear. It increases activity of the prefrontal cortex, according to PET scans, which means that your ability to process things.
In light of their own experiences and the research, what do people hope happens in the future?
You know, I love to see it legalized so that people can actually pay someone else, or, you know, have it free or covered by insurance, what have you, to go in and have a trained therapist provide that session, especially to people who, you know, might not know what the drug is, or they think it's, you know, they have this negative connotation.
I would like to see more funding given to the research. I wouldn't suggest that people go out on it on their own. I know that a lot of people are searching for some kind of salvation. Don't go for it on a street corner. I hope that there's more money devoted to this by the government.
I think these things should be approached with respect and a sort of foresight, not to just like jack your mind off for the weekend or something like that. I think they should be like spiritual and, you know, honored, and then you'll gain what you're looking for.
You know, something that's been, you know, recreational for so long and gotten a bad rep for that. Mm-hmm. It's cool to see it move in a healthy, good direction.
Overall, I agree with my guests. I think this drug should probably be approved. We'll wait for the results of the phase 3 clinical trials. But from what I've heard from them, and from what I've read in the research, this drug sounds like a very helpful thing. But when you make up your own mind about MDMA, bear in mind a couple things we didn't discuss. It's not a harmless drug. It can cause addiction. It can actually lead to brain damage if it's taken frequently and in high doses. Also, using the class of drugs known as psychedelics on a large scale for therapeutic purposes, that's uncharted territory.